Okay, what's going on? This is the host with the most, Mr. Bro Rogan, and we walking in. First, we gotta do the fit check, let these niggas know he ain't playing. But before we get into all that, man, this is the season finale of the Why Not podcast. We here and live at the Why Not studio, so I just wanted to get it in, come in, speak with my folks, and like do a rundown of what we've been up to. So I want y'all to go ahead, like, subscribe, and hit the thumbs up, and let's get into the season finale of Why Not. Let's get it. It's gonna get going. This gonna be one for the ages. Now, here I am, and what is the Why Not podcast without? How you do your work so well. Boom, boom.
Hey, what's going on? It's your host with the most again, Mr. Bro Rogan, and this is the Why Not podcast, buddy. And today, as you can see, there's no guest because this is the Why Not season wrap-up show. And I just want to first give thanks to everyone who was a part of the first season of Why Not. So I'm just going to go over a few of these names, and we're going to go and, you know, throw up a few clips so you can see what it was about. First off, I want to give thanks to Mr. Philly Blunt. Man, it's been a while, man. And go ahead and support Mr. Philly Blunt and listen to his album, The Selfless Heartbreaker. But me and Philly had a good time. We did a few shows together, and you can go ahead and check that out on the channel. We did, I believe, maybe 3 or 4 episodes. Yeah, they're throwing up the fingers in the back. It was 3, and you can go ahead and check those out. And here goes a few clips. Bam.
Let me tell y'all something, because this is a good segue. I fucking love Drake.
Really?
I love that nigga, man. Really? And the reason why, and you can chop me up, to me, Drake is the greatest rapper ever. The greatest rapper ever. I'm turning all my cameras because I want you niggas to feel me from all angles. So as a Drake fan, I said, fuck, this nigga got a dope rollout. Because not only did he just drop a great album with 21 Savage, he's preparing you for a tour. And before this tour started, he let everybody know, I'm putting out a book. As you can see, I have books here. I'm reading books. So I said, nigga, it was hard. Nigga, I've been on Amazon. They kept telling me I stopped. I went to Barnes & Noble. They didn't have Drake book in Barnes & Noble. Y'all gotta fix that. I know y'all have Aubrey book Barnes & Noble, but that's a whole other topic. Finally, I get my Drake book, guys. You see the book, right? So I got it through Amazon. Finally, it arrived. So I get home. It said it arrived. I couldn't find the motherfucker. So I'm like, where the fuck is my book? Go get my dogs. I walk my dogs in the backyard, walk them to the side of my house where they pee and shit. I see my fucking Amazon package all, like, you know, my dog trying to bite through it. So it got little marks or whatever. But then I open it. I'm like, nigga, finally, I get Drake book. Look.
Drizzy.
Titles ruin everything. I'm excited. Got my gumbo, got my shoes off. I got Jack Ryan on paws. Because the match that I watched from earlier, I recorded, so I was gonna watch the tennis match. My nigga know I love fucking tennis. Boom! So I open it up, I say Tracy. In the intro, oh, this is such a good intro. It said, may your neighbors respect you, trouble neglect you, angels protect you, and heaven accept you. Words from the great Aubrey Graham. That's how he introduced us. I said, damn, that's a hard intro. Over the next page. The shit was blank, bro. Open the second page. The shit was blank, bro. So, nigga, the whole fucking book was blank.
blank.
Also, I want to give props to Miss Christina Kurz. She was one of, I believe she was our first official guest, because at the time, Philly was still a co-host on the show. So, excuse me. Our first official guest was Miss Christina Kurz. You can follow her on Instagram at Christina Kurz and all of the other platforms. We had her in. We got to talking, and we had some good stories. Shout out to Sherman. I remember that part from the interview. You can find that clip on YouTube, the Sherman. And for those who don't know what I'm talking about, check out the clip, and you'll never forget the name Sherman. I think that will be your husband's new name after that.
Wisconsin. Fond du Lac, Wisconsin.
Wait. Hold on. Say that with the mic in your mouth this time.
Fond du Lac, Wisconsin.
Fond du Lac, Wisconsin.
Fond du Lac, a.k.a. Fond du Lac.
Who the fuck ever heard of that? How many? So what's the population of Fond du Lac, Wisconsin?
40,000.
Is there niggas there?
No.
Really?
There was two black kids in my school.
What were their names? Tyrone and James.
No, David.
Are we talking like real blacks or kind of blacks?
No,
like
real,
we're
real.
Not talking about like an East Indian dude who was darker than all of you guys, and you're like black.
No.
Sinjay.
David and oh my god, his cousin. His name
Damon.
Started with an S.
It was Shaquan.
No. Fuck.
Whatever, but so there were
Sherman.
Sherman, that nigga.
Sherman.
What?
One time I was at my girlfriend's house, and I remember we took him up to the bedroom.
Oh, shit, Sherman.
And we made him show us his dick.
Was Sherman holding?
Sherman was holding.
He pulled out a weapon on y'all?
He did.
But like, as a 12-year-old.
I don't think he was circumcised either.
It makes it bigger when you're not.
Right.
I'm thank God I am, but it adds extra length.
I've come up close and personal with an uncircumcised one.
Ew, but no, I'm joking. I wish I still had my extra meat. But listen, Sherman at 12, and you and Lily said, Sherman, show me your dick. And he just pulled that motherfucker out with that black man confidence, because he was like, yo, I'm about to show y'all some shit that's going to change your life. Also, shout out to my cousin Jay Black. He should be here right now, but, you know, we all have lives and we be busy. We have a few episodes, him and I. Especially, go ahead and check out the episode with him and I talking about us growing up here. I believe it's titled Growing Pains. Check out that show. We really get in depth into like the early stages of our lives. And like I've always said, everything that we talk about is 100% authentic. It's no exaggerations. Everything we say in that story is 100% the truth. We have the evidence to back it up. But it's just an introduction of how we grew up and probably why we are the way we are now.
Exactly.
Like, tell these niggas about, like, your last day in the shop. Like,
oh yeah,
you ain't even got to say names if you don't want, but, like, your last day in the shop, that where you was just fed up.
Oh, yeah. After all the put-ons.
Oh, I see niggas
put-offs.
Put-offs. DPs.
Shooting, running out the shop, shooting at cars. It was wild.
Murders.
Like, the day I left, it was 6 niggas fighting in the shop, 3-on-3.
One time.
Yeah. And
some well-reputable niggas,
exactly,
too.
Some reputable niggas.
Some reputable niggas.
Well known in these LA streets.
Well known.
It was an incident where somebody bumped into somebody's car.
Uh-huh.
They get out. You know, they confronting each other about the little accident or whatever. And one of them, dope fiend.
Which is socking somebody when they're not looking, for the people that don't
know. Exactly. For the people that don't know, you just take off on somebody when they're not expecting.
Uh-huh.
So he dope in him. He knock him out. He get up. He like, man, I know y'all from the barbershop. Like, you know what I'm saying? They like, fuck
the
barbershop. Like, you know what I'm saying?
Whoop-dee-whoop.
LA nigga shit. Just being extra.
Extra.
Out, right?
You niggas know.
And so, like, it's crazy, like, because both parties was on their way to the shop.
Without even knowing.
Without even knowing.
That's insane.
So, like, so I don't remember who got there first, but I think the three guys got there first, because it was three guys, and then it was the one guy, you know, who got dope fanned or whatever.
Yeah, okay.
So they come in the shot. I think the three guys came in the shot
first.
They
was in there in the chairs already. Yeah, I remember.
And they was like, yeah, we just got into it with a fool. And he's talking about, yeah, I know y'all from the barbershop, this, that, and the other.
Fuck so, shot.
So he walk in like.
The nigga who got dope fanned happened to walk in while the guys who dope fanned him are sitting in the shop.
It's sitting in the shop.
That's
so
crazy.
Like, yeah, he like, yeah, I just got into a little fender bender and like they dope fiend me, and then he like, yeah, these
it's him.
Yeah, these guys right here, as a matter of fact. So one of them jump up, he like, yeah, I'm the one that dope fiend you. Like, what, you want that fade? So like he look around
the young nigga.
Yeah, he look around for a second. He
see
like
two of his homies in there.
He like, my homies in here, I'm in the barbershop. I can't turn the fade down.
He ain't turning no fade down.
He like, oh, like
what he say?
So he like, fuck it. He took his chain off. Ooh. The niggas go to the back.
And they he hanging with the nigga though.
He hanging with my nigga. Like they, you know, it was a good head up little squabble. Then my other guy, you know what I'm saying, he end up getting, you know what I'm saying, the best of him or whatever, start getting him in a chokehold, choking him out, choking him to the ground.
Like he was going to kill him.
Like he was going to kill him.
We
like,
thought he was going to kill him. Like he wasn't trying to put a sleeper hold on him. He was like trying to take his life.
I'm about to take his.
Yeah, I'm going
to
kill this nigga.
I'm about to take his last breath.
Yeah, he like that nigga that hit me a few times in my lip.
Also, I want to give a shout out to Miss Dina Ray. What's up, Dina Ray? Now Dina was one of our early guests, and if you didn't know, she was a young woman who actually sang on a few of Eminem's tracks, which one of them was my favorite song. I can't be your Superman and a slew of others. So shout out to Dina Ray. She will be a guest on the show comes next season.
I was actually picking up food from Jerry's Deli.
I love Jerry's.
Remember the Jerry's Deli that was open across the street from the Beverly Center?
Of course.
Before they closed down.
Of course.
Exactly.
Of course,
so
I know Jerry.
Picking up food, and Justin Trugman rolls up on me with this new artist in his car. And Justin used to play soccer with my brother, so this is like a little brother homie thing.
Uh-huh.
And M asked him, he was like, yo, who the fuck is that?
Yeah. Ooh. I also want to go ahead and give a shout out to Miss DJ Denise, and that is DJ DENYC. For y'all that don't know, go ahead and check her out on all the platforms. But she, not only did we have fun with that interview, we also did a rave here. It was our first party here in the Why Not studio. So if you have time, go ahead and check out the stream. I believe we live streamed it from we live streamed it from GoGoPix, and also we live streamed it from her official DJ Denise channel. So go ahead and check that out. Shout out to DJ Denise. And as of right now, and this isn't taking anything from any of my other guests, but my biggest show today, which I'm still geeked off of, we had Mr. Corrupt Young Gotti come on the show, man. And as a hip hop historian and as a West Coast legend that I am, I was able to sit down with another West Coast legend, and not only did I get to sit down and chop it up with Corrupt, I got to rap with the nigga, man. I got to rap with him. Yeah, I was a little mediocre bars I spit, but it's all good, because how many of you guys, my age or above can actually say that. How many of you guys, because half of us know all of his raps from all of the Snoop songs or the Dog Pound songs that we sing along with those songs, but how many of you niggas can really say you got to rap with him, not his own verse, but to rap your own lyrics? Well, Mr. Bro Rogan got a chance to do that, and I did that. So shout out to Corrupt Young Gotti and all the Gottis.
Simply irresistible. She's just so fine. Yeah, she's fine as wine.
Yeah.
Yeah. She's one of a kind.
Hey,
a girl that I want by my side.
Hey. Thank you. Hey,
why
listen.
Are you gonna stop it? Cause...
Nigga, we keep going. You want me to go after you?
All right, go.
Can I rap with Corrupt? Yo, guys, listen.
Well, go for it.
Hey.
Okay. Fuck it.
Hey. I'm the best MC you gonna probably hear. Don't believe me. Go ask my cousin Amir. Tell you how I put the end of many niggas' careers. I've been rapping since Bin Laden started growing his beard. Anybody wanna fuck with me? They get sliced. I'm the nigga that'll roll you up like some dice. This is all off of the top of the dome. Nigga, I roam like a fucking cellular phone. Kick you right in your mother... Nah, I can't do that, nigga.
I'm the type of nigga that'll crack your bitch. Tell your bitch who she should be fucking with. Run up in this motherfucker. They call me Twitch because I did a movie. I'm just too groovy. I'm running through the streets. This is the game. I'ma show you something you ain't never seen. First thing I was thinking about was, which gun should I use? The 9 or the M16? Let me just switch this game. Let me tell you about me, nigga. Nigga, this is a thing. One thing about Corrupt, man, I just don't give a fuck.
Hey!
Man, I just don't give a fuck.
So wait, listen.
Man, I just don't give a fuck. Man, I just don't give a fuck.
Not Corrupt.
Let me tell you one thing about Corrupt. Run up in this motherfucker with my hands up, ready to sock the first nigga that run up. I tell that nigga what's cracking, don't come to a gunfight with a knife.
Cause your ass will get killed, lose your life. Now look, Corrupt.
Man,
I gotta
stop. Who made that beat?
That's us. That's ours. That's everything
mine.
You hear,
that's mine.
Also, that led us to another interview, which I really, really had a good time doing. And it was the guy who actually hooked up the interview. Shout out to Kid Gotti, the nephew. Shout out to Kid Gotti.
I grew up in this shit, seeing this shit. I grew up as a kid being at Can-Am Studios, nigga. As a kid, as a baby, coming through. And, man, I done been there. As a kid, just growing up, I grew up in it. So as I got older to really visualize it, though, I'm like, oh, okay, this is what we doing?
All right,
this
is
what I'm part of. So this shit's serious. I take it serious. Like, this really my bloodline. It's my life. We stand on this. Like, this shit is real.
And plus, when you got that pumping through your blood, you can't help but take it serious.
So with the Kid Gotti episode, there's something we're going to start doing here at the Why Not Studios. We're going to start interviewing our guests and actually challenging them to jump on the mic. As you can see, there's a curtain right here to my left. Maybe you can't see it, but there's a microphone set up. And everybody who does music or claim to do music or want to get into music, once you come onto this podcast, to this platform, oh, we're going to make sure you get on that mic. And Kid Gotti got on the mic, and not only did he get on that mic, he left that motherfucker torch. He did a great song. So you niggas is playing. You should be ashamed of yourself. Go ahead and check that out. Shout out to Mr. Kid Gotti.
Shout out my bro Rogan. Why Not Podcast.
You know, I played the cards that I was dealt.
Huh?
A young nigga, I went through it by myself. No complaining, I ain't need nobody help. You niggas fake, should be ashamed of yourself. You niggas hatin', should be ashamed of yourself. You niggas playin', should be ashamed of yourself. What we doing, bro? What we doing, Brody? Why not?
Another guest that we had on the show that I gotta give my props to was my boy Stoney the Diller. Stoney out of the projects, let's go. We brought Stoney on, and me and Stoney got to chop it up. And I really liked the episode that Stoney and I had, because a lot of times I have guests, or a lot of times people go on other platforms and they talk about their upbringing, and a lot of guys want to get the negative things out of their guests. See, me, I'm kind of the opposite. Like, I don't want to just hear about the bad shit. So me and Stoney got to talk about some, like, really life things. We got to talk about, like, his respect for his mother and him not falling into the whole penitentiary reform and just a lot of stuff. And we had a great conversation. There was something I said on that show that I had to send to my daughter, and it was just the admiration for women. And that was an episode I think all you women should check out, because we really got in depth into your importance in this world. So go ahead and check out that Stoney the Dealer episode. It is on the Why Not podcast page. Look for the, you know, my logo, man. Go ahead and if you're not subscribed, man, you better fucking hit the button to subscribe.
I pride myself on being an individual. Like, exactly. You get what I'm saying? Like, that's like one of the strongest things you can be as a human being. Like,
yes, it
is.
You get
what I'm saying? Like, for yourself. Like, self-love is very important. You get what I'm saying? And you only can have self-love truly when you're an individual.
And when you love yourself.
You get what I'm saying? Like, when you become an individual, you understand, you can see things outside of your, the way you want them to be, outside of your feeling. You can just call it black and white.
And it just fill me on this. And this might be a little harsh, but that's why I have a problem when a girl, let's say you meet a young lady today, mm-hmm. right?
Right.
And she got her long, nice weave in, and she got her eyelashes done, and she got her butt done, and her tits done. Mm-hmm. And you're not really giving her the attention she wants. And she mm-hmm. says, Stoney, I don't think you're loving me enough. And you say, well, goddamn, how can I love you when you don't even like what God gave you?
Yeah,
you don't even love what God gave you. You going, if God can't please you, how the fuck not?
Yeah.
And that's how I feel. Yeah. These women don't understand, like, you are going against how you were made. And I'm all for bettering yourself. Yeah. Believe me, I'm not. Believe me.
No, I hear what you're saying.
I'm not saying don't do any of it, but I'm just saying these girls have so much going on with themselves. I don't think they love themselves, because it's like you overdoing it, baby.
And another person I want to give a shout out to, Mr. Rockstar 2800. Let's go. He came on this motherfucker and he had to air it out. He had to let you niggas know about he and Wax situation. He got it off his chest. He said a few things that he said he was dying to get off of his chest. And hopefully you guys watch the show and get his perspective, get his side of the story, and see where he is right now. So shout out to Smut Free TV and Mr. Rockstar 2800.
Fuck all that. I just want to clear this up, nigga. I don't fuck with that nigga Wack no more.
Keep it going.
You know what I'm saying? Because I see a lot of shit on the internet. I see this shit. I just saw some shit the other day talking about I called him
and
informed
him
about Big. Bro, I don't talk to this man, bro.
Well, give me
this man is blocked from my phone, blocked from Instagram, blocked from, bro, he can't
listen.
He can't come in my room on Clubhouse. I don't want no attachments to this man.
Answer this for me, please.
Once I'm done with you, I'm done. Nigga, cross me. Nigga, out of there. Nigga, making up lies. Nigga, and that's what it looked like. Niggas running out of content.
And last but not least, our last guest that we had, we actually were able to have him twice. He's becoming one of my favorite individuals on the internet. Also, one of my favorite people outside of the internet, because we do talk away from the show. And I just want to say, brother, stay safe, stay dangerous out here. And that is my guy, Mr. Faux Extras. Shout out Faux Extras
back. You know what I'm talking about? But the thing is, like, when we do come up, you know what I'm talking about, and we share our life stories with the world and all that, I look at it like, you know what I'm talking about? Give that man, you know what I'm saying, what he's supposed to get. You know what I'm saying?
Because
there's a lot of people out here that play people, that be trying to get over on people.
Right.
You know what I'm talking about? And swindle people out of their stuff. You get what I'm saying? You want to hear that man's story? You know what I'm saying? Pay that man what he's worth. You know what I'm saying? Get that man what he's supposed to get. You get what I'm saying? If people want to hear it, you know what I'm talking about? Because life stories out here, you know what I'm saying? It's not a game.
Right.
You know
not
what I'm
at
saying?
All.
And a lot of stuff, how people grew up out here, a lot of people out here done died and got life out here.
Right.
You get what I'm saying? Seen their friends die.
Right.
Seen their family members die. You know what I'm saying? It's hard out here. You get what I'm saying?
Boy.
I'm not saying it's no different from other places. But on the West Coast, you get what I'm saying? Out here, it's a whole different ball game. Look at you now, though.
Man, I'm trying to get it.
Look at this motherfucker.
Look at this motherfucker. I wish we could spin the camera around.
Big motherfucker.
Nice, right?
What the fuck?
Every time I come to this motherfucker,
nigga,
I get the same nigga, feeling.
Nigga, I fuck the bitch right over the window.
Boy,
look at
the roof.
City. You off the roof.
You got Let
me nail the bitch. Let me nail the bitch over the roof.
I'm down, man. Hey, the door's always open for you. You want to bring a little bitch to the...
Lock it in, bitch. If you want to get fucked over the roof, lock it in.
Get at him. Hey, you're going to have bitches getting at you. You're going to have a slew of bitches like, I bend over for you. When the sun up or when the sun down.
Extras, man. I can't wait to get you back on here. We got some stuff planned for the next season. So as far as what we have a lot of things planned with this show, man. Thanks to everyone that's helping us grow. We are currently sitting at, I don't want to give a number, man, but we out there, man. We started from nothing, man. Just know that first episode when you watched me and Philly and we came in here, and I believe the first episode we were talking about Ice Cube and we were talking about Tony Yayo, dumbass.
Because I need to set them straight. And, you question EFN about storytelling as if Ice Cube wasn't. Do you not know that it was a good day? That you can't, who can't relate to that? That's a great story, right?
We had only, I believe, 12 subscribers at that time. And we are now a few, 100 or 2 away from 10,000. So let's give it up for the Why Not podcast for the growth. We are almost at 10K. I want you guys to help us get to 10K, because once we get to 10K, it's over. In no time we'll be at 100, and after that we'll be at 1 million, and we are really going to take over this internet. And one more thing before I go, because I have something for everyone just in case you guys forgot. Hey, back to the star of the whole season, the blank Drake book. You had to come back and make your rounds. So, if you've been following the page, you know I was sent a blank book by Mr. Aubrey Graham, whom I still am a fan of. Don't get your panties up in a bunch, what they would say. This is not a shot at you. This is just me letting you know what I think you owe me. And let's go over that list again, Mr. Drake, Mr. Aubrey Graham, Everything Consciousness. You still owe the Why Not Studio 4 backstage passes, 4 pairs of the Nike Air Max, the special OVO ones with the Jesus on it. You know which ones I'm talking about. The ones you can't find anywhere. Yeah, we need 4 pair of those. We also need at least 1 OVO chain iced out. No, as a matter of fact, make it 3. Shit, everybody in this motherfucker should wear it. Oh, fuck it. Make it 4. Make it even. And just know, Drake, you my guy. But I just cannot let you get away with this. I can't let you get away with the Ponzi scheme. And like I said from the first episode, I was going to mention this every episode. So before we go and wrap up this season, you have to make your debut once again, the blank book that Drake sent me. So other than that, man, we had a great season, man. Season 2 is going to be even better. I promise you, it's going to be bigger. I'm going to let my guests talk a lot more because, I've been reading the comments and I've noticed a lot of times in the videos I probably overtake the interview a lot of times. So I'm getting better, guys, I promise. Another thing is I want to really, really stress the fact that this is more than just an LA podcast. I know I mention that a lot. I talk about the city. I talk about me being from here. But just know that everyone is included and everyone is invited on this show. So it's not just, I'm just bringing on the LA people. I want guests from all over, from all parts of the world, people who never been to a hood, people who are from a hood, people who live in the hills. So I just want to put that out there because this next season is going to be huge. Shout out to GoGo Picks. Shout out to Hoffamaniac. Shout out to the Why Not Podcast. Shout out to Bro Rogan, Hoff the Director, and we are gone. Let's go.